Hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. I'm so glad that you could join us today. I'm showing you this picture because I received this box of Stabilo. I think they're called Woodies. They're actually big chunky water-soluble crayons, and they are so cool. And I wanted really badly to use them in this project today. And you're going to see how it goes. So I've pulled out a light, like almost turquoisey color, and I'm just putting it down on some watercolor. This is Strathmore 400 series, 140 pound cold press watercolor paper on a spiral notebook style. And I'm using a quite large Simply Simmons, I think it's a 26 round brush. It's like a big mop. And a little clean water, and I went directly to paper, scribbled it on, and then got it wet, and I didn't like that look, and then I scribbled the crayon onto my mat there on the right and got it wet and used it like a palette, and it just really wimped out. I mean, once it got wet, it was like no real color, and I knew that was not going to work for a galaxy painting. I knew what I needed was something a little bit more intense, or a lot more intense actually, and so I got my M. Graham watercolors out. And I'm using the cobalt teal in my M. Graham series and some water. And then I'm going to be adding in some quinrose, and look at that. I'm going to do a whole list of colors and everything on my blog post, so if you really want to see exactly what all colors I used and everything, we'll do that there, and which brands and everything. So let me explain to you why this started. So I've noticed that almost every artist I follow has at one point or another done galaxy painting, and some I know that's almost all they do. They love galaxy paintings, and I've never really seen the draw. Not necessarily that there wasn't a reason to do them, but that for me personally, like, why? I didn't need to. And then my nephew came to visit, and he was like, "Aunt Heather, I want to paint the solar system." And I'm like, "Oh, okay, so how are you going to do that?" Because he's an artist in his own, so I always let him tell me how to do it. I never tell him how to do anything. So I'm like, "Well, how are you going to do that?" And he goes, "Well, first I need to paint it black." So I gave him all the supplies that he asked for, and he sat down and he painted. And you'll see he brings it over to me while I'm painting to dry it off, so you'll see it in here a few times. But anyway, I was like, well, that's actually kind of a good idea. I think I want to do a galaxy painting or solar system or sky or whatever. And so I knew a couple of things. In all of the paintings that I have seen, almost all of the paintings that I've liked have a couple things. One, multiple layers of both stars and colors. See, there's why it's painting so far. And so multiple layers, and I really wanted it to have lots of color, because I noticed that although maybe it's because I watched the NASA page, but their Hubble telescope photos are colorful, and I really wanted mine to be colorful. So I first layer is just really bright, vibrant colors in these splotchy areas all over the place. And then my idea was to cover it with a layer of black. Now, I could not for the life of me find a brand new tube of Daniel Smith Lunar Black watercolor paint. I do not know what has happened to it. I know I spent probably $15 on it. I have never used it, and I cannot find it. That devastating moment aside, I went, well, I do have black in other paint sources, so I'll get out my Mission Gold series, and that's what I'm using here. And I have like a black and the really dark gray that are right next to each other there, and I'm just sort of mixing those. And right away I realized this isn't going to work. So I'm adding purples and blues in there as well. And I knew it wouldn't work because the paint for Mission Gold paints are not as well pigmented as like the M grams. So a big reason why I chose to start with the M grams was because I knew that they would go on the page and pretty much stay on the page. These mission golds, especially on this paper, they lift. And as you'll see soon, they dry back a lot. And so I really knew that this was going to have to be like even more layers than I originally thought it would be. So I thought, well, let's have some fun. While the black is still wet, and you notice you can see those underneath colors, those undercolors are still there. But while that was still wet, I'm dropping in some of those brighter colors, bright greens, bright blues, bright pinks, and I'm just sort of dragging them through so they look almost, like that galaxy misty look. This looks terrible at this stage of the game. And as a matter of fact, my nephew came over and went, "Aunt Heather, you're doing it wrong." And in a way, he might be right. Maybe this is like the worst way to do a galaxy painting, but I'm enjoying it. I'm really enjoying it, especially when I start putting in these details, these lines, and these blooms start happening, letting the bright, intense colors bloom and push away some of that dark watercolors. Really kind of cool. So I do speed this up in a few places just because if I didn't, it would have been a 50-minute long video, and I didn't think you'd want to sit through the whole thing, especially when it's tedious like this. So I do use like the belly of the brush in some places to sort of push the paint around, but this was where it really got fun. I used a dry paper towel while it was still wet, and as you see here, I'm picking up some spots, and then as the paint that's wet sort of fills in and softens some of those edges, it's really cool because it looks like wispy atmosphere. So, oh, and then I started adding color in to some of these areas where the paper towel had picked up some paint, and I didn't want it to be white, but I definitely didn't want it to be, like a bright green or something. So I'm just gently layering dark and light and using those contrasts to really define some puffy, galaxy, wispy, universe-like stuff. And I go between a really big brush and then some smaller brushes and pick it up and move it and let it sort of slide all over the place. It's really kind of cool. So let's go ahead and dry this. And I am using my embossing heat tool, and there is my nephew's piece again. And as you see it dry, and this is really cool because we have it sped up so fast, but you can see it dry back almost before your eyes. And I do dab up a little bit more with that paper towel as I'm drying it, so I get different layers of that wispiness. But see how much it dried back? I mean, it's almost like there's no black at all, which really made me miss my Daniel Smith Lunar Black tube of paint even more. But that's fine, because I'm going to make it better. I'm going to bring back those original paints, the M gram paints, and we're going to go even deeper. But first, I think we need to get some white stars in here because another thing that I've noticed with other with these other paintings is that either there's way too many stars or it's just one layer of stars, so it doesn't have any depth. And so my initial thought was, going back to those Stabilo woodies, is I'm going to try the white crayon and see what it's like. And I try this quite a bit, almost like I'm not going to give up. I'm rubbing it over there on the right. That's what you see me doing there, rubbing it on the palette. Then I use a wet brush to add liquid to it so it makes it more fluid that I can splatter the dots on, as it were. And it's really kind of frustrating because it's so little. So then I grab the I mean, it's almost non-existent. I grab the pencil itself and try to, get a more concentrated white from the pencil itself. Then I flicked it off the end. I mean, I was trying every way I could to get as much white pigment out of this crayon for stars, and it really was non-existent, honestly, but I'm not one to give up, so I'm going to keep trying and keep trying. Yeah, I'm just very frustrating. So I caved in. At this point, I was like, you know what? I'm only going to achieve this if I get some white acrylic paint. So I put this is fluid acrylic by DecoArt Media. It's translucent white, which was unwise. Translucent white. Just think about this for a second. It's translucent, not opaque. Translucent white. Read your labels. That's what I suggest. Read your labels, because I didn't. And I'm like, why, when it dried, it was like it didn't exist? Because I use translucent white. I mean, they're there. You can kind of see them. But anyway, I thought acrylic paint would be a wise decision. So there you go. It's dry. The paint's dry. Yeah, that wasn't enough. So I'm going to get this toothbrush. No, it's not the one I use. It's an old one, promise. And I put that into the puddle of paint and squirted it on like this. Like, just use my thumb to just sort of pull across the top of the bristles. And it made them more splattery, concentrated, little tiny dots. Very, very nice. I did let that dry. I know it doesn't look like I did, but I did dry it before I moved on to this stage. So here I am now, and I am back to the M. Graham paints because I know they're going to be more concentrated with color. They're definitely going to be better pigmented, and they are also going to stay and not move as I do this step. So you see now I'm using a Raphael. No, I'm sorry, not Raphael. It's a Rosemary and Company. Pointed round is the 301. And I'm using this because it holds a lot of paint and a lot of water. So it's good, has good retention of the liquid. And then it also has a good body to the brush head. So when I push, I have a nice tip that I can move around. But then when I push with the body, the belly of the brush, I can actually get those flat circular motions that you see me doing there, which allow it to have some dark and some light areas. So now this circular pattern came to me when I was doing one or the other little the bright colors that you see in the background. I was doing those and I was like, oh, you know what? That's what this needs. It's too flat. It needs movement. And so I knew that if I combine some dark deep purples, blues, that and then a little bit of water, just a little bit of water here and there, I would be able to have this darker galaxy feel. And because I had used white acrylic paint for the stars in the background, they're still shining through in most cases. So I'm getting that layer and that depth that I really wanted and I was aiming for. And I just use the belly of the brush to push around some of that paint, leave it deeper, more concentrated, darker in some places, go back in and fill in as you see me doing here. And then really just keep on moving around and giving it that I don't know, it's just depth and concentration. I don't know how else to explain it. But you'll see as I dry this, it does not dry back the way that the layer of black did. And I left these drying parts in because I wanted you to see that happen. I mean, I didn't want it to like break away, it's dark, and then we come back and now it's just poofy light. But you'll see that it is holding on to a lot of that depth and the shape of those movements in the brush strokes that I put in there, those round puffies. Really makes a huge difference as far as it looking so deep and concentrated. So now I really liked the way that toothbrush created both large and small splatters, although I don't really like that big large blob at the bottom there. I'm going to deal with that. But I do like, see, as I started to dry it, I dabbed it, dried it, dabbed it, dried it, and that alleviated some of that blob. But I do like how in some areas it's really a fine mist, and in other places it's big, large dots. And then I used a Signo, is that what this is called? Yeah, this Uniball Signo pen to intensify some of the stars, make them look more like they're shining. I don't know if that was necessary. I wanted to do some kind of like swirly galaxy looking things. That didn't pan out either, but the idea was I was having fun. I was actually having a really good time and I enjoyed it so much. And I shared these pictures on Instagram and I liked the response that I got, but I decided it still didn't answer what I wanted to do in the first place, which was use those chubby pencils. So I found in my stash this drawing paper. And this drawing paper is a black 90-pound drawing paper, so it's not made for water. Okay, so keep that in mind. But what it is made for is these chubby pencils. I mean, I'm telling you, I feel like this paper and these pencils were should have been a set you buy because they are brilliant on this. And I'm trying to, there are so many possibilities with these pencils, and I'm going to talk about them more in future videos and stuff. But I basically just, the page is already black, so I know I don't have to add black, but I want that color, that movement. So I'm using some of the same principles, but you're going to see this is going to go much quicker. And not because, just because I sped up the video, but I'm saying because I took what I learned from the last one and added movement. And like right from the very beginning, so I scribbled in circles and then I used the belly of the brush to move that around. And I'm going to do this. This layer is all going to be done in a way that doesn't add too much water, but it adds enough to make them very wispy and very much in the background. So this is layer one. And I have to tell you, I'm using this brush. It's called, I think it's Best, BESTE. It's a number 12 round by Creative Mark. And I'm using this brush because it does not hold a lot of water. And I remember it's 90-pound drawing paper. I don't want a lot of water on that paper. So every time I put the brush in and I dry it off a little bit on the edge, or I'll dab it on that paper towel, it is only wet enough to move the color. It is not wet in the sense that I could watercolor with it. And that's what I like about those particular brushes. When I don't want a lot of water, I use those brushes because they don't hold a lot of water. So then the next layer then is this the white stars. And what I did for this one is instead of using white acrylic paint, I actually used white gouache, which is an opaque watercolor, and I used Da Vinci Paint Company gouache for this. And that was really smart, I must say, because once it dried, then we could really have some fun with it. And I also used the Nuvo Aqua Shimmer Midas Touch. It is a gold aqua shimmer pen. Yummy. Oh my gosh, yummy. So make sure you dry it before you do anything else. And then I added a little bit of those stars with the Signo pen. And so this is, so layer one was that wispy, colorful background. Layer two is a layer of, a good layer of stars. Not overdone, but done so that there's a layer in the background. And then I really thought I would have sped this part up, but I guess I didn't. Yeah, and then make sure it's all really dry. And there you can see the shimmer of that gold. And you can kind of see that the pencil is a little bit waxy. You might have seen the shimmer, or not shimmer, but the shine from the waxy pencil. So that's an interesting concept. So now we're going to go back in with some brighter color. And I'm going to be more specific about where I put these bright colors. I want some of them to blend together want some of them to accent the other colors. And then I went in with the white to create these wispy sort of gases, I guess, gaseous, you know, like gas in the sky. That's what I'm going for there. And then again, this brush that holds very little water, and I'm making sure that I don't have it too wet, and I'm going in with the tip to sort of spread out like veins of color, but then I'm using the belly of the brush to push around that color in circular motions, but with very little water so that I'm not really destroying the color saturation. Like in the very first layer, I didn't do a great job of holding onto the color saturation, but that wasn't the intention. The intention there was to have a layer far off in the distance. So now this is going to be much more visually in front, this layer that we're working on. And so, like I said, I would just go in with that. It is a damp brush, it is not wet. And I dab it into the water and then I dab it on the paper towel so that I have very little liquid that enough to get it wet and move it, but not so much that it destroys my paper. And there I had a little too much, so I had to dab it up with that paper towel. So now you'll see I'm going to sort of blend these two colors together. I got like a turquoisey green and a yellow, and just sort of travel across the page with it. Let it be a little bit more wispy in certain areas and deeper concentrated color in other areas. And that just really gave a very simple galaxy look to this. Now, I wanted those white areas to be more like gas, like I said, and so I thought they should be more straight through, like it's running through the clouds, running through the mist, running through the star. What do you call all that stuff? It's out there above the atmosphere, so it's not clouds. You know what I'm saying. Boy, I hope you know what I'm saying. Okay, so now let's zoom in for just a little bit so you can see this in a closer. So you see, I use the tip of the brush to spread it out, sort of making those circular motions. And then I get up closer on the brush so that I have more control of the tip. And you see how I just spread that out a little bit. And then if I really want that bottom to be even wispier, I'll just push more with the belly of the brush. And then we'll just do the same thing through the rest of these little wispy cloud thingies. So while you're watching this, I want to tell you real quick about some things that are going on. I am planning and working my way towards every weekday doing some live streaming over on a platform called Twitch. Now, Twitch is most known for gamers to be able to stream their gaming over there, and it is kind of look that way when you first get over there, but we're trying to change that. We're trying to make it so that it's not just about gaming, and I really feel like it's a place where we can do some fun things together. It's got a different atmosphere than YouTube. It's more of like a hangout and have it on in the background noise factor. It's just a different laid back thing. So instead of having a show to get done or whatever, I may be working on backgrounds, maybe cleaning up my space, I may be finishing up some projects, maybe do a project but not actually finish it in a day, those kind of things. And I'm going to be working on that over there. So I'd love it if you come join me and see things over on Twitch. And I've got a lot of things I've been working on, and we'll talk more about that over in the live streams over there. So I hope you've enjoyed this. This has been a lot of fun for me. Some pictures there of the final product. And if you have enjoyed it, please give us a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and leave us a comment below. Thanks so much for watching, and have a very crafty day.